everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share three updos. One of them is a ponytail, but I'm going to just call it an updo. So let me know in the comment section which of the three hairstyles is your favorite. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell, all the usual things, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing off the two sections of hair on both sides of my head above both of my ears. I'm going to be using these later on in the hairstyle, so I just want to clip them out of the way. Then I'm going to combine the rest of my hair together at the nape of my neck. I'm going to tie off the hair with a hairband, and then I'm going to go back over the crown of my head and gently pull on small sections just to add some texture to the crown section. Now with the two side sections, I'm going to create the twisted part of the hairstyle. So starting with the hair on the right side, I'm going to first divide out some hair to leave out around my face. And then I'm going to take the hair and twist it together upwards and then gently pull on the edges to loosen it up a bit and also to make it a little bit fuller. And then I'm going to grab my hairspray just to make sure the hair is smoothed down. I don't want anything sticky now. I want this to be a really sleek style. Then I'm just going to clip it over the ponytail so I can use it later. Then I'm going to take the hair from the left side and create another twisted section. So I'm going to twist the hair together and then gently pull on the edges of the twist so it's fuller than before. And now I'm going to take both twists and tie them together. So I'm just using an elastic band and I'm going to tie the hair together right above the hairband. And to make sure the two twists are twisted, I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic. The hair can just loosen up even though you've already twisted it and pulled it apart. So I'm just going to flip the ends around the elastic and then I'm going to go back over both of them again and gently pull on the edges so they're fuller. And now I need to hide the hairband since there's two of them. So to hide them, I'm just going to divide off a section of hair from the ponytail. And I'm going to wrap the section of hair around both of the hairbands. And then I'm going to tie another elastic band over the ponytail just underneath the wrapped piece. And you want to make sure to include the little ends. This is what will hold the hair in place. And it will also hide it underneath that wrapped section so it doesn't show. And then I also decided to embellish this hairstyle with a pearl headband. This is from my store, Missy Sue Shop, so I will leave a link to this particular headband down below in the description box in case you want to check it out. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to combine all of my hair at the nape of my neck. So I'm going to first divide off some hair to frame my face like usual, and then I'm going to mist the crown with hairspray and comb down the hair to smooth down any flyaways. I want the crown section to be really smooth. And now I'm going to tie a hairband over the hair and create a bun. So on the last wrap of the elastic, I'm only going to pull the hair partway through and this will form a loop. And then I'm going to grab my hairspray and smooth the looped part of the bun just to make sure the hair is smoothed down. I don't want anything sticky now. I want this to be a really sleek style. So now I'm going to tie a hair scarf around the looped section of the bun. So I'm leaving out the ends and I'm going to tie the scarf once underneath the looped section. And then what I'm going to do is tuck one side of the hair scarf around the hairband so it doesn't fall loose. I folded the scarf in such a way that it wouldn't be too long on the sides, but because of that, if I tie it in a regular knot, it will create a big bulky section underneath the bun. So tucking one side through the elastic band will help hold it in place. And I've been getting a lot of questions about where I get my hair scarves. And so this particular scarf is now available from my online store as well, so I will link to it down in the description box below. You can click down there to check this out as well. For the third hairstyle, I'm going to brush all of my hair together at the nape of my neck again, and I'm dividing out some hair to frame my face like usual. And then I'm going to tie the hair into a low ponytail using a clear elastic band, or you can use a hair band, either way works. So now I'm just going to divide the ponytail into two sections, and starting with the hair on the left side, I'm going to place my right index finger on the left side of the section, and then what I'm going to do is grip the hair with my finger and twist my hand upwards towards the right side of my head. This is going to wrap the hair together into a twist, and then I'm going to press the twist against my head with my left hand and then let go with my right hand. And now I'm going to pin the twist in place, so I'm just sliding bobby pins into the hair that's against my head. So I'm only gripping small sections of hair from the twist and then a little bit of hair from against my head. I put in about 2 bobby pins on the right side and 2 on the left side. And then when you let go of the twist, it should kind of fall loose or fluff out to form the top part of the bun. So now I'm going to do the same process with the other section of hair. So I'm wrapping my right index finger over the hair and then twisting my hand so the hair twists up around itself. And then I'm going to set the twist against my head next to the previous section, but a little bit lower than the left side. And then I'm going to pin the twist in place, sliding bobby pins along my head underneath the twists so they grip the hair from the twist and the hair against my head. And you just want to keep pinning until it feels like you can move your head without the hair coming loose. I also laid the hair flush against my head and slid some more bobby pins in so the bun was tucked against my head and not poking out very far. And then once it's all pinned and I feel like it'll stay in place, I went over a few other pieces and gently pulled them out so the bun was a little bit more symmetrical in different places. And then the last thing to do is pin up the end pieces. And the easiest way to do this is to grab a clear elastic band and just tie it over the ends. This will keep them combined together and make pinning them easier. So then I'm just going to tuck the hair underneath the bun and pin it in place with some more bobby pins. And once it's all pinned up, I went back over the bun to make sure I liked the way it looked from each angle and gently loosened the hair underneath to make sure it was symmetrical all the way around. And then since the other two styles had hair accessories, I decided to add some little pearl pins around the bun. That wraps up today's tutorial. Let me know in the comment section which of the 3 hairstyles was your favorite. Also, be sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss future videos, and I will see you next time.